Howdy, folks. Some of y'all probably recognize the 10-horse Allis-Chalmers motor from the late 1910s, early 1920s that I've been working on to restore. Well, I figured out what I'm going to actually do with it. I actually have a use for this motor. Some of y'all have heard me talking and complaining about my rotary phase converter making a lot of noise, and the capacitors, some of the capacitors are missing. So I'm going to use this motor for a phase converter motor. Now, I know it's oversized and not completely ideal for that, but it will give me an actual use for this, and I think that'll be really cool. So this pile of parts you see right here is basically the rest of the parts to make a rotary phase converter, minus one more of these relays. I'm missing one. So what we have, this obviously is the control panel. I'll have one light to show when the thing is running, and another light to show when the start capacitors are engaged. This switch will select the output on or off, and then over here I'm going to have a remote control input where I can use just a two-wire switch and switch the output on and off remotely. That's something that I didn't have on my last one that I would have liked. And then this is a two-button station for start and stop for the converter motor. Now this is the control power transformer. We'll step the 240 down to 24 volt because all this control stuff is 24 volt power. And then this is a very important part. This is the potential relay. And what that does, it will monitor the voltage on the motor winding. And once it's up to speed and producing voltage on the derived phase, it will kick out the start capacitors. These three are for starting of the motor, and when a heavy load is thrown on the unit and pulls the voltage down on the derived phase, the potential relay will kick them back in to help start the motor connected as a load. Now this contactor can be used to engage these capacitors. Then have two here for the main input and output. Either one can be used. They're just different models. Both of them are good. This is the motor overload relay. It's like a circuit breaker. If too many amps flow through the winding of the motor, it'll turn the system off. Control relay will work with this button station for start-stop. Control relay, the overload, button station work together. Then these two groups of capacitors, one group is the run caps that will always be connected to the motor to help raise the voltage on the B phase or the derived phase. And then the second set is boost capacitors that will be added in as necessary if the voltage dips a little bit due to a motor load being connected. And it'll need a second potential relay to control the boost capacitors. And then this contactor switches them on and off. So that's all the working parts of it. Now I've got to come up with a way to package it. And what I think I'm going to do is make a wooden base that comes out a good ways beyond the motor, in a box right here for all the works of it. So that's the plan, and I'm going to try to move forward with some of the aspects of it and maybe get something interesting going. Howdy, folks. As you can see, I've made a little progress on the phase converter build. Got the Allis-Chalmers motor mounted on this wooden base with wheels. I've got most of the components mounted here. I don't have the boost or run capacitors installed yet, and I haven't built the control panel. But what I want to do is I'm going to make a test run of it without those capacitors. Now, normally, if you have a 10 horsepower motor for a phase converter, it'll struggle to start another 10 horse. It would have a hard time doing that. Now, this one, even without boost or run caps, we're going to start that 10 horse motor over there. Now, I don't have the controls, so I'm just going to use this wire and put it in there. That's the same thing as pushing the start button. So I'm going to start the converter motor. Alright, now when I put it in this other port, it'll send power to that motor. We're going to start the 10 horse motor over there. That didn't struggle at all. Turn the output off. It would have started even quicker if it had the boost capacitors in place. Go for one more start with that output, turn on the output here. That motor over there was a grain dryer fan motor. It's like a 3450 RPM motor, 10 horsepower. Without the controls to stop the converter motor, I have to actually loosen this and take this blue wire out. It activates the stop function. So the way this works, this over here is a control power transformer. All the switching stuff is 24 volts. Now, of course, the bigger wires are 240, so I don't want to touch them, but it's okay to handle that. It's a step down. All right, to give a better idea how this actually works, it's actually really simple. We'll turn off the input power here. So this is the input contactor. This is where the single phase power comes in. That middle pole is not used. It was a three pole contactor, but only these two for the incoming 240 volt line. So when this closes, it's sending it through these wires here and into the motor. Now, this is an overload relay. It's just a circuit breaker. But instead of breaking the power lines through there, it just breaks this control signal. So if this trips, it turns off this contactor, cuts the power to the motor. So when you turn on the system, that goes down. Single phase 240 goes into the motor. At the same time, the potential relay is measuring through these two little black wires, it's measuring the voltage that the motor is producing on the center phase, the B phase. And when there's no voltage on these two contacts here with the black wires, get that out of the way, then this is normally closed. So when there's motor's not running and there's no voltage coming off the B phase, these contacts are closed, and that energizes the capacitor contactor. And then that is, you can see the blue wires here. The capacitor is connected between B phase and one of the input. So until it builds up speed and voltage, this potential relay has this pulled in, and the start capacitors are in operation. So I'm going to turn on the power again, and you can see it in action. Try to get all the contactors in view here. So you'll see this one, and this one will turn on, and then that one will turn off as soon as the motor picks up speed. So here we'll go for a start. That's exactly how that part of it's supposed to work. And if I take out this wire, the control relay will turn off, and you'll see that drop pop up and stop the motor. So that's how that works. Put that back in. Now the overload relay has a test trip function. On the back of it back there is a little button I can push. So I'm going to start it again here. Now to simulate if it was getting abused and overworked, I'll push this little trip button back here. if I can find it. And so that disengaged the control relay and stopped it. So again, the next thing I got to do is build an enclosure around all this and get the capacitors hooked up for the run and the boost. And it'll be good to go. The boost caps work the same way as the start. This is their relay. There'll be a second potential relay that works at a... It doesn't have to have as low of a voltage to engage. That way, if there's just a moderate load on the system, it'll work. Well, that's it for today. I hope everyone had a Merry Christmas. I sure did. And had a lot of fun putting this together. Catch you later.